Hello my dears, welcome to biggest platform of learning wisdom era. In today's class we shall learn about harmful microorganisms. Microorganisms are harmful in many ways. Some of the microorganisms cause diseases in human beings, plants and animals. Such disease causing microorganisms are called pathogens. Some microorganisms spoil food, clothing and leather. Let us study one more about the harmful activities. Disease causing microorganisms in humans. Pathogens enter our body through the air we breathe, water we drink, or the food we eat. They can also get transmitted by direct contact with an infected person or carried by an animal. Microbial diseases that can spread from an infected person to a healthy person is called as communicable diseases. Example of such disease is airborne diseases. Common cold. It's a viral infection. When a person suffers from common cold, sneezes, fine droplets of moisture carrying thousands of viruses are spread in the air. The virus may enter the body of a healthy person while breathing and causes infection. So, we have to use a handkerchief whenever a person is suffering from common cold, and a healthy person should be far away from the person. We shall learn about more diseases which are communicable by air. Example, tuberculosis, measles, chickenpox and polio. These are caused by some of the microorganisms like bacteria and viruses. And these causes infection to a healthy person. Preventive measure is keep the patient in complete isolation. Keep the personal belongings of a patient away from those of the others, and vaccination should be given at a suitable age. Next one is waterborne communicable diseases. That is, cholera, typhoid and hepatitis B are waterborne diseases, and these are caused by pathogens called bacteria and virus. These diseases causes severe infection in a person. What are the preventive measures? Means maintain personal hygiene and good sanitary habits. Consume properly cooked food and boiled drinking water. And vaccination should be given to the diseases to prevent this from a infection. Next one is communicable diseases or disease caused by carriers. Most common carriers are housefly and mosquito. These carry the protozoans which cause infection in a human body. When they sit on a garbage, they will carry those infection causing protozoans in them, and when they sit on a food, they transfer those infection causing microorganisms to the food. When we consume that, we suffer from the cholera or the disease which is caused by the pathogen. So, preventive measure is we have to cover always the cooked food. And female Anopheles mosquito carries a parasite causing malaria, that is Plasmodium. And female Aedes mosquito carries viruses of dengue. This causes severe infection to human beings, which leads to death also. So, preventive measure is we have to control the population of mosquitoes. Mosquitoes always breed in the water. So, we have to control the spread of malaria and dengue just by not collecting water anywhere. That may be in tires, coolers or flower pot. And also keep our surroundings clean and dry always. Use mosquito nets, mosquito repellents or spraying insecticides also avoid the breeding of mosquitoes in a water. Next one is disease causing microorganisms in animals. Several microorganisms not only cause disease in humans and plants but also in animals. Anthrax is a dangerous human and cattle disease caused by bacterium. Foot and mouth disease of cattle is caused by a virus. It is avoided by vaccination. Next one is disease causing microorganisms in plants. In plants, several microorganisms cause diseases like plant disease. Example for plant diseases are citrus canker, and it is caused by bacteria and it is transmitted through the air. Rust of wheat is caused by fungus and it is transmitted through air as well as seeds. And yellow vein mosaic of okra or bindi, it is caused by a virus and its mode of transmission is insects. Through insects, these diseases are transmitted. Now we shall learn about food poisoning. Even though some of the microorganisms are beneficial to human beings, they cause food poisoning. When the leftover bread is seen after some days, we can see the growth of microorganisms on it, and those release the toxic substances, which is not suitable to eat. If we eat such foods which are poisonous, and if we go through those foods, then it will be leads to severe condition like food poisoning, and later it may lead to the death also. So we should not consume such foods which are poisoned. How can we come to know the food is spoiled? Means it will be bad smell, bad taste or change in color. So we should always cover a food with the coverings. Methods of food preservation. Chemical method. You might have seen in your home your grandmother is doing some pickles, and that does not spoil for a long time. Why the mango pickle is not spoiled? Just because she is adding salt and edible oil, which prevent the growth of microorganisms in food. So preservation by salts and edible oil prevents the growth of microorganisms. Salt or acid preservatives prevent the attack of microbes in pickles. Just like sodium benzoate and sodium metabisulfate is the chemicals used to preserve some common jams and squashes. Next one is preservation by common salt. With the help of common salt, we can preserve meat and fish. Just because meat and fish are covered with a dry salt, where it forms a salt layer which will prevent the growth of bacteria. With the help of common salt, we can also preserve amla, mangoes and tamarind for a long use. Next one is preservation by sugar. Sugar have ability to absorb water. Sugar can absorb the water content and reduces the moisture, which prevent the growth of microorganisms. So it is used in jams, jellies and squashes to preserve it for a long time. Next one is preservation by oil and vinegar. Oil and vinegar does not allow the bacteria to grow. So some vegetables and fruits, fish as well as meat are covered with the oil or vinegar to avoid the growth of microorganisms. Next one is heat and cold treatments. Microorganisms cannot grow in hot surroundings and also cold surroundings. Boiling of food kills the microorganisms, as well as refrigeration of food items in a low temperature also kills the microorganisms or prevent their growth. Next one is pasteurization. Pasteurization means cow's milk is heated at about 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 30 minutes and then chilled suddenly, and it is preserved in a bottle for the use, which is free from harmful microorganisms. And this method is first discovered by Louis Pasteur,
hence it is called as pasteurization. Next one is storage and packing. It prevents the growth of microorganisms. Some dry fruits and vegetables are packed in polythene bags and sealed in airtight packets, where it will prevent the growth of microorganisms. Next one is nitrogen cycle. Like oxygen, nitrogen is also very necessary for the growth of plants. If nitrogen is not present in a good manner, it reduces the crop production. The color of leaves will change, and also it is dangerous to microorganisms which are in a soil. At about 78% of nitrogen is present in our atmosphere, and this nitrogen goes into the soil by biotic components, and this will again enter into the atmosphere. This is called as nitrogen cycle. And this nitrogen cycle involves 5 steps. First one is nitrogen fixation. Second one is nitrogen assimilation. Third one is ammonification. Fourth one is nitrification. And fifth one is denitrification. Let us learn one by one. Plants cannot utilize atmospheric nitrogen, so it should be converted into utilizable form such as ammonia. First one, nitrogen fixation. This is the first step of nitrogen fixation or nitrogen cycle. This atmospheric nitrogen is converted into ammonia for living organisms is known as nitrogen fixation. And this process is carried out by leguminous plants such as groundnut. Even some bacteria fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Examples of such bacteria are Azotobacter, Clostridium, Rhizobium, Nostrac and Anabina. These helps in nitrogen fixation. Next one is nitrogen assimilation. The process of absorbing nitrates and ammonia into organic nitrogen is known as nitrogen assimilation. Organic nitrogen is transferred into animal's body when plants are eaten by animals. Next one is ammonification. The process of converting organic nitrogen into ammonia when animals die is known as ammonification. It is also known as mineralization. And this process is carried out by some saprophytes like fungi and bacteria, which feed on dead and decaying matter. Ammonia is also produced from volcanic eruptions and excretory products of animals. Next one is nitrification. The bacteria which is involved in nitrification is known as nitrifying bacteria. Here the ammonia is converted into nitrites. Those bacteria are Nitrococcus and Nitrosomonas. And these bacteria converts nitrites into nitrates. That is called Nitrobacter. Next one is denitrification. Here the nitrates are converted into molecular nitrogen through nitric oxide is known as denitrification. In order to maintain the equilibrium of nitrogen in atmosphere, denitrification is very necessary. Bacteria which are involved in denitrification are known as denitrifying bacteria. Example, Theobacillus denitrificans, Pseudomonas denitrificans and Micrococcus denitrificans. Problems with increase of nitrogen. It leads to the acid rain formation, and also it leads to the nitrification in the soil, which leads to the death of plants. Thank you, my dears.